Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And for our final segment for this edition of Cairo Local Time, we move to the latest in the exciting world of sports, where Al Ahli faces Talaa Al Ghaish tonight in the Egyptian Cup final showdown for Egypt's Cup, which will be held at Burj Al Arab Stadium in Alexandria. Now, the Red Devils qualified to the finals after defeating Al Ittihad of Alexandria 2-1 on Tuesday in the semifinal round. Meanwhile, Talaa Al Ghaish booked their place in the final after beating Al-Zamalek 3-1 in the other semi-final game. A short break and we'll be right back for a further in-depth discussion, of course, of tonight's game, the Egypt Cup final showdown, so do stay tuned for that. Welcome back. And now we're delighted to be joined over the telephone by Mr. Abdelaziz Abu Hamar, the sports critic. A very good afternoon to you, sir.
Good afternoon to you and to everyone.
Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Abdelaziz. Now, first, let me ask you about the Egypt Cup competition. Could you give us a bit of background? When did this competition actually start?
Well, it is, let's say, a deep-rooted history.
Yes.
It is, in fact, it started in 1922. That shows how Egypt have a very deep football and sports legacy.
Yes.
Started, as we said, in 1922.
Mm-hmm.
The first final was between Zamalek and Ittihad of Alexandria. Zamalek won. Zamalek was the first title holder.
Mm.
Zamalek won that time 5-0. It was also like today an Egyptian referee, Youssef Mohammed. And, you know, since then, the cup developed and has taken us to 2022, where is today's final, Ahli and Talaa Al Ghaish.
Yes.
Talaa Al Ghaish is for the first time in the final.
Mm-hmm. Talaa Al Ghaish, in your opinion, was it an unexpected team to reach the finals?
Yes, it's the first time. It's the first time for the club to reach the final. It is the number 52 for Al Ahli to hit the title
to reach the
final. Ahli, as everyone knows, is the 36th title, and Ahli is waiting for the title number 37, or Talaa Al Ghaish for the first or depart title, let us say.
Indeed. Tell me, in your opinion, Mr. Abdelaziz, what is different in this year's championship, especially with the latest developments in the sports sector in general?
Well, we have to really give some tribute to the EFA, Egypt Football Federation.
Mm.
As everyone knows, this season or this year, all the competitions around the world were badly hit.
Yes.
By the coronavirus, as everyone knows. For us, is to take the league to the end, whereas Ahli was crowned as the title holder, and now today the last final day of the Egypt Cup.
Yes.
And also we managed to entertain or to host some of the Champions League, CAF Champions League and CAF Confederations Cup. So the entire system works in a good way during the coronavirus, where this pandemic, you know, made everything very difficult in
yes,
the world.
Yes, absolutely.
There is still a lot of stadiums closed around the world. But let's say we have found the good protocol, and based on that, we've worked hard, as everyone knows. And now, it is the last day of the season. Let's say 2019-2020 season. So it's really very good. It was difficult, but let's say Egypt and EFA, we have managed to bypass these obstacles and or this challenge by working together and cooperating, it's good also for the country. It's that's why the Cup, Egypt Cup, we don't see it from the competitive way, rather than on how the system works in Egypt. And now we are in the final, and the final is between Ahli and Talaa Al Jaish. And this is the most important thing. One club is going to win the title, as usual. But the difference remains is the corona, and the pandemic really made things very difficult. Mm. But thank God we're there to manage these challenges through EFA, Egyptian Football Federation, through the country itself, through media, through stakeholders, all sports and football stakeholders in the region.
Indeed.
Right. Sorry, in Egypt.
Mm-hmm. Yes, carry on, Mr. Abdelaziz, I'm listening.
Yeah, I mean, all stakeholders, all football stakeholders in Egypt, they really did their part.
Mm-hmm.
And thanks to them all.
Yes. Indeed. Right. Mr. Abdelaziz, what are your expectations for tonight's match?
Sorry, you come up again?
Yes. Yes, I was asking you about your expectations for the match this evening.
Well, you know, Al Ahli is a local champion, is the league champion. Al Ahli also is a continental champion, so Al Ahli is the favorite.
Hmm.
But hopefully, we could see a new competitive side.
Yes,
we need Talaa Al Jaish to be a very hard card in the final.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I think this kind of matches, it needs patience, it needs accumulative let us say experience.
Mm-hmm.
And Ahli is much more experienced in the final phase.
Yes, right. Mr. Abdelaziz, there was talk of maybe financial prizes and so on, financial gains and returns for the winning teams. Is that correct?
The winning team?
Yes, financial rewards.
Yeah, I think there is in regulation of the competition, yes, the winning side is getting some money, some financial benefits, because mm-hmm. you know there is also some resources from the TV rights and from all that.
Right.
But to be honest, also it's not as much as we see outside the financial revenues in the local competition is not lucrative, let us say. And I want to tell you something, Angie, before I'm afraid you said thank you. I liked your report just before this inputs.
Yes.
About the declines of poverty in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
I liked it too much.
Thank
just
you very
please, carry on.
Thank you very much, Mr. Abdelaziz. This was an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us this afternoon and for all your insight, Mr. Abdelaziz Abu Hamar, our sports critic. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, another short break and we'll be right back. Do stay tuned.